So let's think about some very early monies, historical monies. Economists think that perhaps cows were one of the earliest forms of money as we recognize it as a medium of exchange. Well, what would make a cow a good money? Well, it's portable. They can go from place to place, and everybody pretty much knows what a cow is when you look at it. So it's recognizable. Cows are relatively durable, but they require some effort to feed and maintain over time. Perhaps the biggest drawback of a cow is that they're not very divisible. So generally, people that exchange for livestock or cows tended to be only involved in relatively large transactions. This was not the sort of money that you could easily use for an everyday sort of purchase. But over time, the things that we see people use as money has evolved. Certain things have demonstrated their ability to improve upon these basic characteristics of money in a way that was advantageous. So, for example, shells quite frequently circulated as money around the globe. In a place called the Maldive Islands, for example, came a little shell called a cowrie. Cowrie shells circulated across most of Asia, most of Africa, and far into Europe for many, many centuries. Because people understood what these things were, they understood it had a certain value, and they were willing to trade for it. In some civilizations, governments have stepped in to supply a money, much to their advantage. So, for example, the first coins emerged in a place that is now Turkey, but at the time was called Lydia. Lydia was a kingdom that sat at a crossroads of trade. It was somewhere connecting Asia with Africa and Europe. Most people who had things that they wanted to exchange with other cultures had to pass through Lydia, and Lydia was an opportune trading place. What Lydia also had was an element called electrum, which is some part silver, some part gold, that people understood had a certain value as far as its beauty was concerned. The king of Lydia, Croesus, stumbled upon the idea that if he stamped pieces of electrum with his official seal in various denominations, that people would use them in exchange and would make Lydia a much more popular trading destination. And these were our first coins. And they had all the characteristics you would expect to see in a modern money. They were very divisible. They were easily portable. They were durable because they were essentially gold and silver. And most importantly, they were recognizable. People could see the symbol of the king and they understood exactly what its value was. On the North American continent, I think we've seen the same evolution in the characteristics of money. So very early on in North America, trade between the native peoples and the Europeans were often conducted in something called wampum, which is a bead that is made from a quahog clamshell. Wampum was a legal tender in many of the colonies. Also seen in the colonies circulating as money was tobacco. All of these monies, which I would call commodity monies, have an intrinsic value. And by intrinsic value, I mean they can be used for something other than exchange. Gold and silver is beautiful. So are shells. Tobacco you could smoke. So these provided a bedrock of value for your money. But it's also very expensive to maintain a commodity money. Shells have to be fashioned into some sort of jewelry, coins have to be stamped out, the gold has to be dug from the ground, that sort of thing. Over time, we've seen economies, as they continue to evolve, their monies continue to evolve, we get further and further away from some underlying intrinsic value. And our money just becomes money, something that we accept in exchange because we trust its value.